The Victorian Labour government has abandoned a promise it made about 2 months ago to keep children under 14 out of prison. This decision has sparked anger, outrage and dissatisfaction from community leaders, children's rights advocate groups, First Nations organisations and human rights organisations including Amnesty International. And joining me to explore the decision and its ramifications is Gomeroi woman Kacey Teerman, Amnesty International's Indigenous Rights Campaigner. Kacey Teerman, first of all, thanks for joining us and welcome to NITV Radio.
Hi, thanks so much for having me.
Across the spectrum, the reaction is one of anger, consternation, with many organizations calling the backflip a monumental betrayal.
It's a huge betrayal by the Victorian government that is just going to negatively affect all children, but particularly First Nations children. And these children are the most vulnerable children in the country. Like, a lot of these children have really complex health needs, as well as the fact that we know that when they're under 14, they just don't have the cognitive ability to understand the consequences of their actions in the same way that an adult would.
They're still developing. These are kids. Most of them are just still in developing years and their mental capacity hasn't yet developed. Even physically, they're still yet developing, and yet the government is keen to keep them in incarceration. What would be the reason for the government just dragging its feet? Because it's been years and decades since organizations like Amnesty, children's advocates, community leaders, even international organizations out of Australia have been calling for a change. Why is the government dragging its feet?
You know, that's such a great question. And the fact that they're now backflipping is just really telling that they're willing to use children as a political football. And using this, this youth crime crisis as the reason for not raising the age to 14 makes no sense, because we know that locking up children does not make communities safer.
The excuse they gave is because there's a spike just within 2 months period, not even a year trial, to be able to have more data, more evidence to be able to substantiate their decision, to back up their decision with more data. It's just a 2 months period, because the decision was initially announced to raise the minimum age of criminal responsibility in Victoria was announced back in June. So barely 2 months from now, and within a few weeks, there they are. They just decide to go back to square one. Why would they just keep incarcerating babies?
I think it's a good way for them to just try to get votes, to be honest, because they have all of the legal experts agree, all of the child experts agree, like in health and psychology, that this isn't what we should be doing. We definitely shouldn't be locking up children at 14 years old. It's just such an easy way for them to say, like, we're being tough on crime, when we know that this won't have that effect. This isn't going to make communities safe.
Yeah. Only one, actually, jurisdiction in Australia has actually made a positive move. That's the ACT. We decided to raise the age to 14 by 2025. With some exceptions, and Tasmania has also pledged to raise the minimum age of criminal detention to 14. Victoria was another state that had really indicated they were willing to take a good move. And then, surprisingly, out of the blue, here we are back to square one. Now, what's Amnesty's position going forward? Are they going to keep pushing and advocating for this to happen ASAP?
Yeah, definitely. Victoria had the opportunity to be the first state to actually raise the age without carve-outs. And the fact that they're backflipped on this is, as I said, a huge betrayal. But it's Amnesty's position that we will keep pushing to raise the age of criminal responsibility to at least 14 in line with international standards. And just pushing for greater funding to justice reinvestment and diversion programs, which we know actually work.
Can you give us an example of some of the outstanding achievements through justice reinvestment? Because this is something that's hardly ever spoken. Governments are always just on this same language of tough on crime, zero tolerance and things like that. And yet, if they did something slightly different, something more humane, more actually even evidence-based that it works, they will change the situation without causing so much harm to the community. Can you give us some examples of really successful models of justice reinvestment?
Yeah, for sure. And just on that, obviously, the government has a bunch of reports that's showing the evidence around the fact that locking up children doesn't help anybody and especially doesn't make our community safer. But across the country, what Amnesty is going to be continuing to call for is the better funding for the place-based, community-led diversion programs.
Yeah.
So across the country, there are so many excellent people doing so much great work. And the people, the way that it works is, it has to be based on the community. These communities know what works for them.
Yeah.
And there's not a one-size-fits-all. And we see that in incarceration. That doesn't work. But we know that these place-based alternatives do. So across the country, there's too many to count, but they have, and we have the data from them. We know that when these children engage in these place-based diversion programs, that their chances of reoffending within the first year drop to 80%, to below 80%. It's 80% successful, sorry, getting tangled up in my words.
And yet the government is not looking at this data. It's just hell-bent on following.
Yeah, so they actually actually have this data, and it's across in all the different states and territories in different ways. They have the data that shows that the diversion programs work and they're wildly more successful and have better outcomes than custody children.
Now, Kacey Teerman, before I let you go, anything you'd like to add to the conversation we may have missed that's really crucial and might bring to the attention of our listeners?
Definitely just like to say that the Victorian government backtracking on this is a grave betrayal, and that Amnesty International, along with human rights advocates and the legal organisations, will continue to push for them to raise the age to at least 14 and to support these children.
Kacey Teerman, Amnesty International's Indigenous rights campaigner. Thank you very much for joining us on NITV Radio and sharing concern of Amnesty about Victoria's backflip on its decision to raise the minimum age of criminal responsibility.
Thank you.